Master Spy. There is no pilot.
No pilot? What do you mean, fool?
See for yourself. What does it mean?
I will tell you, my idiot friend. We know already the machine can be flown without a pilot. This means that the cowardly Mr. Mercury dare not meet us face to face, because he knows that this time we have won.
New pilot. Extraordinary. Most extraordinary.
I do not like it, Master Spy. It is a trick. Supercar flying by itself. It is unnatural.
Fool. You suppose perhaps your green ghost is responsible? They have flown it from their laboratory.
No pilot? What can they have in mind?
Don't yell out, Doc, but the pilot's right here.
Curious. Most curious.
Professor, Beaker's okay. He's here with me. Take off fast. We've got them fooled.
Wait a minute, my dear fellow.
Hold it. Beaker's got something.
This would appear to be an excellent opportunity to test the new equipment I was installing.
You mean all those loose wires?
I do indeed. Request them to depress the switch on the wall, would you?
Don't ask me why, but Doc says to throw that taped-up wall switch.
I'll do it, Professor.
What's it all about, Doc?
Something I had designed to scare away inquisitive creatures. I feel that Master Spy is about to fall into the inquisitive category. So perhaps we might climb up and observe.
A heartwarming sight, is it not, friend Zarin? Our very own supercar.
Here goes, Professor.
I still don't like it, Master Spy. Somehow I feel there is something wrong.
Imbecile! How can you possibly...
Well, I never. Instant dancing.
They make a pretty good team, huh? They should be on Broadway. Master Spy, what are you doing here?
I have come to finish our discussion about supercar. And I think what I want is in that case.